Welcome to the St Andrews Senior School Prize Giving and Speech Day 2019. And it is again our great pleasure and our privilege to publicly recognise the academic success of our highest achieving students this morning. The students who are honoured on stage, in many ways though, represent not just their own success, but also the academic success of the whole school. Each year group represented here this morning has, in their own way, pushed back the bar in their academic achievements over the past 12 months. Be it the university offers gained by our current year 13s, the record A star to C GCSE pass rate achieved by our year 12s last year, or the impressive markers set down by this year's year 11 in their January IGCSE English language exams. They have blazed the trail and shown their successors what it is possible to achieve. Having analysed all the exam and report data for this year, I know how closely the prize winners were pushed in so many categories. And I would like to take this opportunity, as I always do, to invite us, the staff, parents and guests to show our appreciation and acknowledgement of the dedication and commitment that is shown by each one of the students of St Andrews Senior School. So please join me now.
Year 13s, your next employer, the place where you go to, they are going to make a judgment of you. My challenge to you, wherever you go, is to remember what happens and result lead a life of integrity. Someone is going to complete your reference. That is guaranteed. And they're always watching you. Your small things, the big things. Sometimes they ask about dress code and things like that. So what I would encourage you to do, live your life well in all that you do. Make sure that you make the most of every moment. So that is my challenge to our year 13s and to all of us.
It is for the students that this school exists. And all their beating hearts and their inquiring minds that help to make us what we are. It is our determination to ensure that the pupils, the students, remain at the centre of our work. Now that may seem a strange thing to say, but so many schools around the world that I have seen do not put the children and students first. They put the interests of the school establishment, its rules, its regulations, and its traditions first. They put the interests of the adults, the teachers, first. And they put the interests of the young people they are there to serve and care for and educate second. Now, as someone who attends countless meetings concerning school business and listens to dozens of conversations between teachers each week, I can assure you this is not the case at Turi. When gold is mined, several tons of dirt must be moved to get 1 ounce of gold. But one doesn't go into the mine looking for dirt. One goes in looking for the gold. And that's exactly how we try to look at the students at Turi, younger and older. We don't look for the flaws, the faults, or the blemishes. We look for the gold. We look for the good and not the bad. All these successful Turians did not arrive in this school with convenient labels plastered across their foreheads which said future highest mark in Kenya in A-level history or geography or sociology, or future place at a top 20 university, or future winner of the Rhino Cup for debating. No, their passion and the teachers, like many before them, went and searched for that seam of gold. And more often than not, as you have witnessed today, they have found it. So what does that take? It takes a whole school of dedicated people, ranging from those who strive in our workforce to our governors. It takes supportive parents and enthusiastic and passionate students. It takes determination, compassion, empathy, understanding, courage, and not a little love. And it certainly takes, in Van Dyck's words, teachers strong and wise, who teach because they love the teacher's task and find their richest prize in eyes that open and minds that ask. And finally, speaking of the governors, I would like to echo what is said before and take this opportunity to thank the chairman for all his outstanding work on behalf of the school.
As always, it's a pleasure to stand before you on a day like today, Speech Day, to celebrate our journey together over the last 1 year. It is that time of the year when we reflect on our respective journeys, whether we are parents, students, or teachers. For some of us, we still have steps to take here at St. Andrew's Turi. For others, our journey here is coming to an end, and we'll now move to new grounds as we remain old Turians. We have shared a lot together, made contributions to our common home, St. Andrew's Turi, and we have learned together.
So I'd now like to invite Ms Wakoli to the stage to present our first awards of the day. And these awards celebrate success in last year's public examinations. So the first award is a new school award, and it's for performance in last year's GCSE exams. Every year 9 student takes a CAT test, which provides the most likely GCSE grade predictions for each student. So the first award, for the highest achievement in GCSE 2018 exams, with an average GCSE score across 10 subjects of 1.4 grades higher than their CAT challenge projection, goes to Michelle Kariuki. The Pearson, EdExcel and Cambridge International Exam Awards, High Achiever Awards from the 2018 GCSE and A-level exams are awarded for exceptional performance in individual exams. And the award for the highest mark in Kenya in GCSE English Literature goes to Sinan Pertev. The award for the highest mark in Kenya in GCSE Sociology goes to Tamara Lugonzo. The award for the highest mark in Kenya in GCE AS level history goes to Shiraza Shalita. The award for the highest mark in Kenya in GCE AS level sociology goes to Lisa Maria Lofty. The award for the highest mark in Kenya, GCE A-level history, goes to Nathan Kiplagat. Now, Nathan is now studying economics and computer science at Tufts University in the United States, and I invite family friend Mrs. Kariuki to come to the stage to collect the award on his behalf. The Year 12 prizes for academic attainment are awarded to Amy Magunda. And Kush Patel. and the Senior Prize for Mathematics and the Chris and Degwa Memorial Trophy for Mathematics is awarded to Jairus and Gary. The Fallon Kendi Memorial Award, awarded for the best all-round record of academic achievement in Year 11, is this year awarded jointly to Sharon Nyanga and Alua Damilola Salam. Turi Academic Achievement Award for the best all-round record of academic achievement in Year 13 is awarded to Ivy Katonga. Master's Award to the outgoing head girl in recognition of service to the school is awarded to Nicole Jean-Louis.
To the student body, this is what I encourage you to do. Year 9s and 10s, you are the beginning of your journey here at senior school. And I urge you to take part in every opportunity you have, because real talk, we're lucky to have them. Year 11s through to 12s, life is presenting you with different paths or choices that determine your future school life. Don't disregard the beautiful path you're on just for the destination. Take satisfaction in the pitfalls, because that's how you learn. And lastly, to the year 13s, my year group, my peers, we're at a crossroad, trying to see who we want to be, what we want to be, and who we will take on this journey. And as much as we've heard the phrase, the world's your oyster, there's so much potential in your future, we must, and I repeat, must not forget to find the pearl in that oyster. Wean out the moments of happiness and joy, because that's what we should look for in life. So, to the people of St. Andrew's Turi, all of you, look for the beauty and good. And if you do that, as Bob Marley says, everything gonna be all right. Thank you.
Wow. You know, me and Nicole really debated about who should go first. I should have gone first. And a good afternoon to the school, parents, other family, friends, mom. Pressure, we all experience it. But every single person here deals with pressure differently. How does pressure influence your choices? It could be pressure to perform well, pressure to impress your friends, pressure to give a good speech on speech day. Now imagine me, the school head boy who also does further math, who performs in front of a huge number of people, going through all this pressure. My philosophy undertaking all of that is a truly spectacular job is done or not done in a moment. A short period of time where you have the center stage. Those few moments where you have to remember that important math formula in the exam. Moments where quick reactions in front of a hockey goal are essential. Or the times where you have to rush to make sure mom, or for some of us boys, Mr. Munene, finds a room neat. This is something I refer to as the make or break period. That little space in time where the race is won or lost, or where the performance is good or bad. And as unfair as it may seem, those opportunities never come back again. A famous quote shared by one of my idols and arguably the greatest finisher ever, Usain Bolt, was, "I never imagined the start of a race before it begins. I only picture the end and where all my training will take me to." Usain Bolt always had a passion, and from the moment he knew he could achieve, all he ever imagined was the finish line of his journey. I would like to request the permission to display my passion to you by quickly performing a little solo piece on the piano. That performance demonstrated my make or break moment. I honestly promise you, I did not know what I was going to play before I went to the piano. And so that only adds on to the pressure facing on to the fact that there are 500 people seated here in the audience. It's been a true honor going up to such a position. Many of you who know me will know I've come from a very far place to reach the heights I never thought I would. All of you will always have a huge spot in my heart, and I truly admire the companionship that I received throughout my time here. And I know they think I forgot about them, but to the teachers who took the time to care for me, even when it seemed like there was no way up from some of the places I hit in my earlier years, I'd like to say thank you and keep blessing the lives of Africa's future generation.
No one is ever too young or too old to live the life of their dreams. I've been privileged to interact with the year 13s, and some of you really, wow, you're amazing. At this young age, you've already discovered your purpose. Some of you want to be in film industry. Some of you want to write books. Some of you want to make a change in your countries when it comes to healthcare, when it comes to women empowerment, and so many other things. What is your purpose? What is that one thing that makes you lose sleep at night? What is that one thing you can die for? Somebody said that, and this is actually a fear by many of us, that we fear death. We wonder how will I die and, you know, all those things. But I believe, having walked this journey, that the greatest tragedy in life is not death. It is living life without purpose. to the Turi community, I challenge you. Dare to reach that unreachable star. And even when you fail, pick yourself up and keep going, because it does not matter how many times you fall down or you fail. What matters is that you pick yourself up, you dust yourself off, and you keep going. Try and dream and try and reach that unreachable dream. Because all things are possible, all things are possible, and there's nothing actually like an unreachable dream. Reach that dream. Dare to push yourself even when your hands are weary, when you're in sorrow. Try and grasp at that star. See it in your dream, see it in your vision, because it is possible. And just remember, never despair, never give up. Keep going. The sun will definitely shine again. Thank you so much, and God bless you.